är fortfarande så roligt att den första era videon jag kommer lägga upp min YouTube kommer handla om Beyblade.
What's up YouTube? This is your girl Cat with a C and welcome to Nerdy Swede, or should I say Nerdy Swedes, because today my cousin is joining us and today we're gonna talk about Beyblade.
Yay!
To 30-year-old sort of gonna talk about Beyblade. Yeah,
best topic ever.
Best topic ever. So instead of actually writing on my paper that I had to do last night, I did some research about Beyblade. So I don't know if you've heard this YouTube, but in the middle 90s, late 90s, there was this kind of big phenomenon called Pokemon. And that sort of took over the world. Started with a game, and then a manga, an anime, and everything around it. And there was a lot of other, you know, similar franchises from Japan in this time, like Digimon also started with a game, and Yu-Gi-Oh! Started with a manga, also became huge and popular, and they were in the same category. One of these were also Beyblade, which was maybe like the fourth biggest out of these three giants, and then Beyblade, because I feel like if you mention like Pokemon, everybody knows what Pokemon is.
Oh, yeah.
But if you mention Digimon, most people,
yeah, most people have heard of it, but yeah. it's like they usually don't like remember what it was about. It's just like it was kind of like Pokemon,
yeah,
but it wasn't Pokemon.
Yeah, and Yu-Gi-Oh! I still think like some people also sort of know what that is. The card games, some heard of it, but Beyblade, I think you have to be a kid in the late 90s and early 2000s to like remember Beyblade. Mm. You didn't like it at first, right?
No, I didn't, but then it was like I sort of just was there when you were watching, because I wasn't present when you watched it the first time, and I was like, well, this looks a bit stupid, I think, and I didn't really get it, and I mean, it is stupid, so...
I mean, you weren't wrong!
I was not wrong, but as both of us thought, Ray was cute.
Yeah,
I thought
course.
Ray was
yeah,
cute.
That
so
was like
I
the
was
main
like
reason.
A little bit hyped because I was like, oh, he's gonna have a fight now, and then the episode was over.
Yeah,
and then she didn't have the next episode.
Although we couldn't really, in the beginning, contain Ray and Tyson or Takao apart.
Yeah, it was like it was like when Tyson was on screen, it was like, is that the good looking one?
Mm-hmm.
But then when Ray came, it's like, no, that's the good looking.
We couldn't tell them apart. Anyway, Beyblade, it was of course, you know, in this era of all these shonen franchises with the games. So it started with like the actual Beyblade, which is like a spinning top that you spin and it's supposed to do.
Yeah, just a toy that spins.
Yeah.
That is like plastic or like metal.
If you watch this video, you'll probably know what Beyblade is, otherwise you wouldn't watch it.
I can't imagine why you would watch it otherwise. Go away. You won't get it.
And then it came a manga, which was fairly successful in Japan, and then it came the anime, which actually was like the breakthrough that it had, and it was translated into several languages, including Swedish, which was the one we watched, of course.
The Swedish dub is amazing.
And it's basically a direct translation from the English one, so
yeah. They're
basically the same. But the Swedish one only actually dubbed the two first seasons.
They did like Metal Fusion and that's the weird thing, and that has made me pretty pissed off, because it's like the first two seasons and they skipped g-revolution and then dubbed like other seasons after that,
which was very weird.
It
shouldn't be that expensive to, I don't know. So we watched the original series like a lot.
a lot. Like, I recorded them from Cartoon Network, and like, you can see which episodes we like the most, because the image is so bad. It's so bad. We have like worn the tape down to shreds.
Yeah.
And I lended you the best one, the Majestics one.
Yeah.
So that looks the worst, because you watch that like every day. So I will never ever borrow her VHS tape again.
Aww. Too bad I don't use VHS anymore. I think we actually sort of understood that it was kind of bad as we watched it.
Yeah.
Not as bad as we understood as we grew older, but still, like, it was like, I mean, when we were 12, I had watched, like, Naruto, and, I mean, one of our first, like, favorite animes of all time, Gingan and Garbushi Gin, and stuff like that, things that aren't, like, they can be stupid, of course, but not as stupid as Beyblade, because Beyblade is extremely stupid.
Yeah, and I mean, we weren't really that interested in the actual game, like, no. Like the Beyblade part.
As it was said, we got interested because we thought Ray was cute.
Yeah, we thought Ray was cute, and then it's sort of the other people start growing on you, and they're like really nice relationships, and so, like some sort of character sort of developments, but then they sort of reverse back. But yeah, it's like it's sort of like the people and the relationships that we really liked. So yeah. The only like Beyblade matches we liked was the one where there was sort of emotional high stakes.
Which is usually like the critique for the first season in general. There are so many matches that aren't like...
Yeah, nobody cares.
Yeah, they don't really matter. And we watched the beginning of V-Force, because it was dubbed into Swedish.
I think I've seen most of V-Force.
Yeah, I've used to see more than I have, because I was...
She didn't have Cartoon Network.
I didn't have Cartoon Network because I live in the fucking woods. So I only watched like... 10, 20 episodes?
Because I recorded quite a lot of episodes. Because I was like, well, it's gonna get better, because the first season is also like, it takes a while. But I know that V-Force, I recorded it for a lot of episodes for long, because I was like, no, but it's Beyblade, it's gonna get better. And then maybe there was like a moment in an episode that I really liked, and I was like, oh, maybe something's happening now. So I continued, but I think I only have like 5 episodes left, yeah. I think, that I sort of saved.
And we never watched the end of it.
Yeah, I don't know what happened. But everything was so stupid. So it was like, it's like in the first season, it feels like there are like a lot of higher stakes going on. But in V-Force, it's like, what was the thing in V-Force? I don't remember.
We can't remember. The only thing we remember is the battle royale thing.
Yeah, they're on an island. And have like these colors of like necklace thingies, like bracelets that they have in like the battle royale, like the Japanese horror movie. That the colors will like explode if they try to like take them off. So they have like I don't know if they would explode in Beyblade.
I can't remember. But maybe in the Japanese version though. I don't know.
Maybe actually, in the Swedish it's like uncommented. I think they don't think they say anything about. Yeah, it's like what is this?
But it's to keep track, right?
Yeah, but I think they checked like pulse and stuff too. So I mean, they would know if they died.
I don't know. The Japanese version is a bit more hardcore, but also stupid. So I don't know. I wrote the written series is too slow. We force just what in my comments. And then g-revolution, that is regarded as the best season. And one of the things that was interesting, I read like the general critiques about all the seasons and why g-revolution is considered the best one. Because the original one, they focused so much on like the Beyblades and like the all the spirits and everything. V-Force, they changed the director for once, and of course they took away like at least what we know. the it's not a world competition. What do you say? World championships.
Yeah,
there's no world championship.
Yeah, and there are no like tournaments in the
it's something, I don't know. And then the g-revolution, they not only took back like lots of the original characters from the first season, they also took back the original director.
Because that is one thing that really drags V-Force down, that it's like only Blade Breakers.
Yeah, but the reason we're doing this video at all is because we just watched g-revolution for the first time in our lives.
Never watched anything, basically. Me, at least.
What?
I watched... g-revolution!
Oh, you mean...
I've never seen, like, few short clips on YouTube. Nothing else. You've seen some episodes.
I've seen 15 of the first episodes, and then I've seen some later episodes. But it was nice seeing it all together. I have seen, like, some episodes without subtitles, and my Japanese is not that good. But this was g-revolution. So it's interesting watching a show that we loved as kids, as adults, with another lens, through another lens.
Yeah, I like to see it for the first time when we're adults.
Yeah.
That is like really interesting.
Exactly. I knew though a lot of what was gonna happen because also I read about it, you know, when you were young.
But it's like we don't really have a nostalgic connection to that season in the same way as we have with like the first and like
but we do first. Have nostalgic connection to like
characters. The universe and the characters.
Because we were talking earlier and we were like, if this show was just a bit better, maybe you could recommend it to people. But if you haven't watched it, I think it's really, really, really hard to get into it as an adult.
Because yeah, you sort of have to have a sort of nostalgic like connection to it.
It's so stupid. And we're gonna come back to this because it's so stupid. G-revolution, regardless, I put up a list of pros and cons. One of the best things, of course, is that so many of the original characters are back. Obviously, we're gonna probably switch around with like the English or Japanese names because, yeah. And also, you know, all the old characters are back, almost all of them. Not the European team, of course.
Like our favorites, like Majestic, they are the best. They're so funny, they're so cute.
Our absolute favorite, and it's not because we are European. We just love these like bitchy rich
spoiled rich brats. Bitch.
We just love them.
Yeah, but they're so funny because it's like they are like they're like so mean to everyone and like the most like the brattiest people. But then they are sort of friends anyways.
Yeah, and they showed up in the end of the first season to actually help the BBA and everything, and it was so sweet.
Yeah,
and
it's like they're just really funny.
Yeah, they're like sort of our favorite team. I know they aren't like the most popular team on Beyblade, but we really, really like them.
Yeah.
And also that Boris or Volkov was there again, and he became the main villain again. Which I mean, it could get tiresome, I guess. For, you know, enemies to have, like, the same villains continuously coming back over and over.
Mm.
But here, Beyblade is so stupid already, and getting to like new characters is hard.
Yeah, so they're not really very good at presenting, like, new characters that are good. I feel like
Game Evolution had some.
Yeah, they had a few. They had a few. But, yeah, it's not so common in Beyblade.
No.
They're not so good at new characters.
And also because since he was back, we have these amazing scenes with Neoborgs.
Yeah, oh my goodness, that was like...
We're gonna talk about this
later. Best episode ever.
Yeah. Another good thing I wrote down was that it was some really, really good fights because there wasn't that much dead time. They skipped over a lot of, or like, hurried through, like, boring matches so we can just focus on a whole episode on, like, Max and Kai or Kai and Ray or whatever, like good fights. So that was so nice.
The fights that you cared about with like characters that you cared about.
Yeah.
And it was like high stakes the whole time, and it was like you didn't really know who's gonna win either.
Not always.
It was like both really could win, it could be a tie, it could be like so that was
especially
really
when they make Takao lose so much in the beginning. because you know he's gonna win anyway because it's fucking shonen. So that's pretty boring. But still having him lose a bit was nice. I also thought it was most nice conflicts within the BBA, like when Max and Ray leaves the team and goes to Otherwise, and also like Takao's own growth. He has to like stumble and really get to go down to get up. I also think they had sort of solid character development, not for all characters, because Baby had a tendency to forget character development and then have the characters go through the same development again.
Yeah.
But, okay.
Like so many American series. That is like classic American series, I feel.
I also thought there was actually some interesting new teams with some interesting dynamic and interesting like storylines comparing to like V-Force. Stuff like that.
God.
And also because they didn't introduce like a ton of characters like the first season did. Mm. Because, I mean, of course the first season had the main character for every like continent sort of. But they had like a ton of minor characters and they like skipped this in the seasons, which was so nice. And this is a thing that is both good and bad. And that is that people got hurt. They got actual...
We love when people get really hurt. It's a thing.
But...
They have to be serious.
Exactly, but there's a big but here. And that is that it doesn't make any sense.
No, it doesn't! It's so stupid! Why? What is happening?
This is the thing with Beyblade. They can do nice stuff, but the reason for it is so stupid that it's just like, what?
And it's like, so often you don't really know how it happened. It's like, okay, he got really hurt. Now, because his Beyblade got hurt, And they have a connection.
They were so extremely inconsistent. But we're gonna go over to the cons now. So there's
this is why I should have read your notes before, because I don't know what we're gonna talk about.
I'm sorry.
She's the worst coach.
I wrote this yesterday. Okay, anyway. I felt that some of the characters, now we watched all of it. I wrote this yesterday when we haven't watched all of it because we just watched it. I felt there were maybe some two underdeveloped characters, especially in the second part. But then I think they got sort of, I don't know, I'm a bit on the fence with that one, because I felt like Garland, he was very weird.
I felt like I never gave a fuck about Garland.
No.
I was just really annoyed with him. He's like,
But there's a difference between, you know, as a perfect preference and actual a development, a character you just
love. Yeah, I know, but I think that was sort of why I didn't like it, because he sort of didn't give me anything. Like, if he had actual...
So he was underdeveloped, you think?
Yeah, I think he was, totally.
Okay.
Super underdeveloped. Like, what was his development?
He played Beyblade with Takao, and he said, you have to love Beyblade, and you have to be your own person.
And he was like, oh my god, you're right!
Like, I couldn't, listen to you when you tell me that, like, Boris was evil and whatever. I didn't listen to that, but I listened to this little kid, I don't know.
And it's like, he turned around like this! Of course! I love Beyblade now, and I was really happy! Weird,
because they feel like they worked out for that match also, because he already fought Yuri, and, like, he really hurt him, and then it was like, oh, we had to have this fight, and then it was over so quickly.
Yeah, it felt good in a way that it was over so quickly, because it was so fucking boring. They were like sort of flying, and it was glitter everywhere. It was so strange.
Other bad things this season is Daichi.
Oh my god.
Horrible.
What's
character.
Up with Daichi? Like, what is this person? Who the fuck made him up? Who created Daichi? I don't like that person.
It was Takao Aoki. Who wrote the manga, of course. This is also obviously a theme for shonen, to have an even more annoying younger character of the main character arrive, so that the main character can seem mature.
It might be that, or he's just so stupid.
Just get a new younger audience or whatever, but he is so annoying.
Yeah, and it's like, he doesn't have any depth at all. It's like, he really is just a comic relief, and then he has like sort of short moments where he's like, oh, he's actually really strong, and now he beat like Tala in like one match, and then he was like, oh, is he okay, he got really hurt, and then they really cared, but it's like,
that was one of the good thing about the second half, because, you know, of course this season is like two halves, there's the world championship and then the bigger storyline, because in the bigger storyline he was like in the one of the first episodes in one of the fights, the first fight, right? The first fight, and he lost, and then I felt like he didn't do anything.
Yeah, he wasn't like so. He didn't do a lot, and he didn't take up so much space. So I mean, that was good.
Yeah, because of course, knowing what happens in like the first part in the world tournament, of course they need another member on the team, but like they could still have been a good character.
Yeah,
it didn't have to be Daichi. I mean, it could still be an actual interesting character, or could it be like Daichi, but you know, a good version of him. I don't know how to do that, but a better version.
Yeah, I mean, the problem is that they just don't, he really is almost only like a comic relief.
Yeah.
And that is sort of the problem.
Annoying.
I hate comic relief.
And he also was in this scene, but the Japanese version is so extremely inconsistent with language, because when they're in the US, they speak, of course it's a Japanese children's anime, everybody's gonna speak Japanese, but then there are scenes when they speak English in the US.
Oh right, that, oh my, that was
And
so
they
sad.
Were like, no, I can't understand you because I am American, but you were like, everybody spoke Japanese a few seconds ago.
Speak English.
Drink.
Oh, sushi. I like sushi. Tempura. Shabu shabu.
When they really need it,
Everybody
speaks the right language and can understand each other. But then when we can have a fun scene where foreigners don't understand each other, then no one speaks Japanese suddenly.
It's so weird. Like, it's not consistent. And I understand it's a children's show and everything, but one of the things that's nice about Beyblade is that it's so... Even though it's problematic also. But it's very now international. So it's all these languages and people and everything from everywhere, which is very, very nice. But it doesn't work really for children.
They don't execute it very well.
No, because if it was like a show for adults, maybe they could use like English as the main language. And then like have the teams, for example, speak like mostly Japanese or Chinese or whatever. That would be interesting. But, you know, honestly, I can't do that. Another con is, her name is Hiromi, right? What's her English name? Hillary. Yeah, and this whole season we were like, what's
she doing there?
What does she do?
What's her thing?
What's her purpose? What's she even? She like
she doesn't
makes,
have an agenda.
No,
at all.
She makes food. She sometimes took care of. She took care of Daichi when
she's
he
sort of like. Yells at them when they're lazy.
Yeah.
And I'm sort of like, you do this and do that.
Yeah, and fights with the cows and with Daichi.
Yeah.
And it's like, okay, is that a character?
It's like, she mostly just sits on the bench.
She's supposed to be like a comic relief, sort of. But the thing about Beyblade.
But she's hardly comic relief, even. She's sort of, she's just there.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because Daichi clearly is comic relief, but Hillary
I would
is,
say that she is comic relief, because...
I think maybe she's intended to be that, but I really don't think she... I still think she is hardly that, because...
Yeah, of course, but this is one of the issues I have with the Japanese version at all. The English is hilarious, but that's just because it's so bad, especially like the Swedish. Oh, the Swedish have some awful, awful voice actors.
Yeah, it's like so mixed, because some are really good, and some are really bad.
Kai's voice actor, for example, is horrible.
His laugh is the funniest laugh ever. But it's like he could laugh like three times, like, ha ha ha, and then he sort of repeat that.
Nu när världsmästerskapet är över, finns inte Blade Breakers längre. Och det betyder att vi inte tävlar med varandra, utan mot varandra.
The Japanese original version, the humor is usually pretty bad.
Mm.
Beyblade is only funny when it's like unintentionally funny because it's stupid. So the actual humor isn't funny.
Yeah.
Which is why the dub is funny, because it's just weird.
Yeah, and because the dub is so insane, they say so strange stuff. You can like really tell that this is not what we're saying in the original. This is just some mumbo jumbo, like some shit that they have just put together because they sort of can't be bothered with doing like the actual. Sorry, because they cut away scenes too, so then they sort of have to change a lot of the lines.
And they just generally think there's too much, like, silence in the animated
thing. My god, yeah!
So they even added, you know, like, three characters that didn't even exist.
Three characters? Is it two?
No. Three?
The
Dizzy, you know, Kenny's computer?
Oh, yeah, of course, Dizzy! Yeah.
She doesn't exist, and then, of course, AJ Topper, and what's the last name?
AJ Topper and Brad Best.
Brad Best, of course, the commentators that we never get to see because they don't exist.
And
you know, basically every time you don't see anyone's mouth or there's anything, there's some sort of voiceover in the English dub saying something. So it's just rubbish, but it's funny.
Yeah, because it's so stupid.
It's so funny.
So strange things they say sometimes.
Yeah, it's like this really, 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 really weird stuff.
Yeah, like the door.
All right. No need to get snippy. What is this, Kai?
It's a door, genius.
Another really bad thing about g-revolution was that Kai's character development, or lack thereof, was pretty bad. We're gonna talk about it later because I have kind of read about all the characters. And also, the rules are always dumb. We were so confused in the beginning. We were like, how many matches are they fighting?
Yeah!
We didn't get it.
So is it three in like three rounds in one match, or is it like
because they also started with like 2-on-2, so then we were like, is it just one match? Yeah. What is going on? We were so confused.
Yeah, and then they had this other system also when it was like 2 fought, and then the one that won was gonna fight late in the third game too.
Yeah,
the other one that won in the other. It was like really. That really took a while.
Yeah.
And also since they changed it.
Yeah.
So then it was like...
And of course, the rules in Beyblade in general are fucking insane.
There are no rules.
Yeah, there are no rules in Beyblade. It's absolutely insane. that we truly got to know in the last episode. Because the last of my notes on here on the cons are, what's real?
Yeah!
This season, what the fuck happened? Was so extremely, I mean, Beyblade like burned the lines of what, like, metaphors and what is actually happening. But this season was insane. There were so many times we had no idea what was going on. We were like, is this real? Are they fighting? Are they in space? What is going on?
Yeah.
One of the best things at it was when the people came with the fire extinguisher and whatever kind of
god! Yeah!
And they actually came with a fire extinguisher, putting the fire out. So obviously his fire was real, but also sometimes the fire like engulfed like his opponents or something.
Yeah, and like, himself as well. When he was gonna do an attack, he was like, flames and fire
so
all over.
Like, shouldn't they be on fire?
Yeah, shouldn't they have burns all over?
It's so weird. It's like, what is actually real? What is happening? It's so... And especially like in the last episode that we
I still
watched,
haven't recovered from the last episode.
That was the stupidest shit I've ever seen. That was like,
what
insanity. There was this black hole,
and it sort of kept coming. It was like, it got worse and worse and worse and worse.
Yeah.
And first people were like, okay, this is like a metaphor, but then it was like, but it really isn't.
It really isn't. He is like a devil or an angel.
Yeah, he became a devil, he created a black hole, and things started to get sucked in, and then the audience got sucked into the
and
black
then
hole.
The whole city?
Yeah, the houses and the cars and
the boats
and like cranes.
And then there was this explosion over whole of Earth.
Yeah, and the Earth was also like engulfed in like dark materia and like fog.
And you're like, this can't be real, right? Because what is happening?
Like the Earth just...
But it is real? Sort of?
Yeah, because I mean, after the match was done, everything was broken.
Yeah.
I mean, the city was smashed.
And there's the reason again, like, how can Beyblading be legal? This cannot be legal. What is going on? People must have died. This is...
Yeah, I mean, they had, like, trashed houses, and, like, that whole building arena was,
yeah.
like, no more.
Yeah.
And then it was sort of, like, and still, like, the kids sort of, when they sort of fallen down from the black hole because they sort of got out, we don't really know how, and then apparently it was safe to fall from the sky down on the ground as well, because everyone was fine.
Just 100 meters or so.
Yeah, and it was like, oh, what happened? Then, oh, the match is still going on! Come on, let's go and look some Beyblade!
Yeah,
and they just ran there, and
truly,
it was so happy.
We truly understand this season that everybody, all the people in Beyblade world are absolutely lunatics, all of them.
This is like a global psychosis that everyone suffers from. No one has escaped this.
Mm.
Everyone is like obsessed with Beyblade, and like all that matters is Beyblade and your love for Beyblade and the fact that you can like sacrifice everything for Beyblade.
They don't care that miners get hurt or sort of almost killed or that they destroy buildings or anything. Nothing matters as long as the Beyblade game is still going on. I wrote down my favorite episodes. I think yours are maybe the same.
They're probably the same.
Probably the same. We're basically the same person. In place number 3, I wrote Max versus Kai.
Oh, it was so cute!
It was such a good episode.
Also, Max and Kai's relationship is like the most beautiful relationship in entire Beyblade.
And they're so consistent.
Yeah, this is a consistent relationship.
Yeah, it's always the same. They have this like mutual respect for each other because nobody can hate Max, although some people did this season, but we're gonna talk about that later. But Kai, I mean, they are amazing, beautiful human beings.
They're so cute. And Kai is like, he's very rarely like straight out mean to Max.
Yeah, basically
he almost like smiles at him sometimes. It's like,
yeah, he smiles this game.
He's unusually nice towards Max consistently, which is like so sweet.
We love that.
We love that.
Okay, and then I put at the second best episode, I put Ray versus Kai.
Oh god, that was also so good. That match! I mean,
it was so amazing. I didn't expect that.
No, and it was like they sort of went in for the kill like immediately, and it was like force all over, and it was crazy, and there was adrenaline.
Yeah, it was
and
so
like,
good.
And it was like, who's gonna win? Like, because they were like super into it, both of them. I really loved it. And then
it was really good.
A little bit angry with Kai because he sort of knocked Ray out, so Ray fainted. And they were like, Excuse you, Kai?
That's supposed to be your friend, dude.
Yeah. And then it was like, okay, sure. He waited to like go on with the match until Ray sort of got up and continued to fight, because that's what you do in a Beyblade game.
Yeah, you don't care if you like kill your friends. Yeah. That's fine.
Yeah.
And at the top, the best episodes, I think, this entire season was episode 35, the Neo Brooks versus Vega. Oh, when they arrived in Japan, it was angry as fuck! Because
it was so good!
Because everybody was idiots and listening to Volcom, and it was like, bitch, no.
Yeah!
This man is absolutely horrible.
Is he nice again?
Yeah.
Is nice again?
Yeah.
He might be.
And I think for us, I actually sort of bought that they sort of thought that because they are kids. And
yeah.
I mean, they are pretty stupid. They really like to believe or think in the good one in everyone. Blah, blah. I mean, like they did with the Neo Borgs in like the first season. I mean, obviously they're friends now. But it was so nice to have characters to come in and not be fooled, like, at all.
Yeah, they didn't buy his bullshit.
No, they suffered through him. They know that he is a horrible, horrible person. And I didn't think that they would actually, like, go in so hard and so emotional. And
no, I was so happy that they did. It was like they came and they were really, really, like, they were so angry. They were, like, boiling. And
yeah.
They came there and
they
were like, you can join me. And they were like, fuck you! And they were, oh god,
yeah.
They were so insulted that he even suggested
yeah,
that.
Yeah, they would rather die than be with him. They were like, no, absolutely not. And it was just a great episode all around. Very, like, intense.
Yeah.
Great characters and everything. Great episode. Also the episode after when Yuri fight Garland and he got, because it was sort of like a two-parter. Really, really good episode. Fucking amazing. I when we watched it, I was like, oh, I wouldn't want to watch that episode again.
Yeah, it was so good.
Hur långt jag kommit på min nazist. Fyra meningar. Inte ens meningar.
Jag trodde att det var en Beyblade-fan. Fick jag bara... Weimarrepubliken. Sexuell dekadens.
Right. Det var inte riktigt det. Det hade typ kunnat vara det. Jag tänkte att jag dumpade i det.